Alright, so today we're gonna be playing The Walking Dead. Alright, it says choose a display style. Standard, more help from UI and feedback when you make important choices. Telltale Game Presents. Alright. How's this? Oh, there's a car. I'm guessing we're in it. Oh, it's a cop car. You give me that look and keep your eyes on the road before we crash.
Well, I reckon you didn't do it then.
Alright, what do we do? You have a limited amount of time to make a choice. B, why do you say that?
Why do you say that?
You know, I've driven a bunch of fellas down to this prison. Lord knows how many. Usually it's about now I get the, I didn't do it.
Every time?
Every time?
Every time.
Well,
we got what looks like a 1091E near Peachtree Exit 35.
What does that mean? Oh, we can look around.
I followed your case a little bit, you being a making boy and all.
So you've got an opinion?
You've got an opinion, man?
Wouldn't say that. I go in for that innocent till proven guilty thing, even considering who they say you killed.
Okay.
I got a nephew up at UGA.
Isaac Carlos so also.
Going on a 6th year.
You meet your wife in Athens? You want to know how I see it?
He doesn't want to talk about it, but. Sure.
Sure.
Talk?
Regardless, could be you just married the wrong woman.
I wouldn't be rude, you know, I mean. What is happening? Why is there helicopters everywhere? I said, bro, that's the only helicopter. What am I on? Jeez!
I'm driving this man once. He was the worst one. He wouldn't stop going on about how he didn't do it. He was an older fella, big soft eyes behind a pair of smart folk glasses. And he just wailing back there. Says it wasn't him. Crying and snotting all over right where you sit.
Keep your eyes on him.
Then before long, he starts kicking the back of the seat like a fussy baby on an airplane. Not telling him he's got to stop. That's government property, and I'll be forced to zap him otherwise. So he stops, and having exhausted all his options, he starts crying out for his mama. Mama, it's all a big mistake. It wasn't me.
So did he do it?
They caught the fucker red-handed, stabbing his wife, cutting her...
Hey, yo, what the fuck?
Dang.
As the boys came through the door. He sits in my car screaming bloody murder that it wasn't him. I think he actually believed it himself. It goes to show, people will up and go mad when they believe their life is over.
Mm-mm.
I got another good one for you. This one's a little bit less depressing and a bit more hilarious if I do say so.
Oh!
This other time-
Oh my god, bro.
Oh, hell no, man. What the fuck, man? Get your ass on, bro.
Bro. That's why you keep your eyes on the road, bro. My god. The way his body was just moving around. Oh my god. Wake up, bro. That boy slumped.
Oh shit. Thirsty.
How you gonna get those off?
Hey, officer, are you all right?
Hey, bro.
I'm still cuffed back here.
I'm like dead. You can see the blood.
Officer?
That doesn't look good. He wasn't ejected from the car.
And by what?
He's not moving.
Yeah, I'm like dead. Alright, let's try and get out of this car. Alright, get out.
I need to drag myself out that window.
Do a flip. Dang. Alright, bruh. Be quiet, because there might be some zombies around. Okay. Alright.
God damn.
Alright. There's the keys. Get them. But how'd you drop the key? Pick it up! Alright, there you go. Alright, let's get the other one.
Officer?
Whoa,
Holy shit!
What do we do?
Get away from me!
What, do you have a shoddy? Oh, get the... where's it at? There it is. Get that shotgun shell.
Oh my god!
Bro, you're fumbling! Pick it up! Alright.
Don't make me do this!
Yeah. Dang. Nah, bro, keep that thing in hand. No. Oh, wait, no, because there was only one shell, so it's useless now.
His skin's all rotten and he smells like shit.
Ugh.
What the hell is this?
What do you think it is?
Are you dead?
Hey! Are you dead?
What's that?
Help!
What? Oh, nah, bro, get up right now. Run. Run to wherever that person was. Oh my god, how do you fall? Get up. Climb over that fence right now. Oh yeah. They can't climb over that. There's no way. We smacked his head. Alright. It's a pretty nice treehouse.
Anybody?
No ladder. I'm not getting up there anyway. This leg the way it is.
Anybody up there?
Hello? Anybody home? I need a little help.
A little? Get in there. Oh, dang it, bro. Oh.
Coming in. Don't shoot, okay?
Alright.
Ah! Shit. Hello? I'm not an intruder. Or one of them.
Alright.
These people might need more help than I do.
What's this? Coloring book? I don't really need to worry about that. Oh! Cup of water? Bet we need that, yeah. And drawer. Yeah, let's look. What's that on the side? Oh, it's a phone. Or a walkie-talkie. Huh. Alright. Something I see he's doing. Nope.
Marshalls. That's a Savannah area code. But that's the type of note you'd leave a babysitter.
What's that? Alright, there was some beeping. I'm guessing that was a phone. Answering machine?
There are three new messages. Message one, left at 5:43 p.m.
What is it?
Hey, Sandra. This is Diana. We're still in Savannah. Ed had a little incident with some crazy guy near the hotel, so we had to get him back to the ER and have it checked out. Anyway, he's not feeling well enough to drive back tonight, so we're staying an extra day. Thanks so much for looking after Clementine, and I promise we'll be back in time before your spring break.
Message two, left at 11:19 p.m.
It was a babysitter. There is a babysitter.
Oh my god, finally. I don't know if you tried to reach us. All the calls are getting dropped. They're not letting us leave and aren't telling us anything about Atlanta. Please, please, just leave the city and take Clementine with you back to Murrieta. I've got to get back to the hospital.
Oh, God.
Please let me know that you're safe.
Message 3, left at 6:51 a.m.
Clementine, baby, if you can hear this, call the police. That's 911. We love you. We love you.
Bro, that's sad. I'm guessing that's a little girl.
Daddy?
Huh?
Oh, the walkie-talkie.
Hello?
You need to be quiet.
Oh, who is this? This is the daughter. This has to be the daughter, right?
Are you okay?
I'm okay. They tried to get me, but I'm hiding until my parents come home.
I don't think your parents were coming home.
What's your name?
I'm Clementine.
Oh.
This is my house.
It is the daughter.
Clementine. I'm Lee. Where are your parents?
They took a trip and left me with Sandra. They're in Savannah, I think.
Where's Sandra? Where the boats at?
Are you safe?
I'm outside in my treehouse. They can't get in.
That's smart.
Oh, so
see?
She was
can
in there.
Can you see me? I can see you through the window.
Huh. Smart. Alright. Oh, shoot. Smacker. This has to be the babysitter, right? Oh shoot, I did the wrong thing and then press B. Oh. Dang. Alright, leave. Bruh, oh my god, you have to have brain damage from that. Yeah, kiss me in the face. Get up. Oh, I heard that crack. Think. Open that door. No. Bro, kicker. Help us! Hey, get up. Take whatever she has. What is it? Give it. Who's that thing? Man, this is gonna traumatize her. Alright, but I think that's enough. There's a little girl right here.
Man. Hi there.
That's not a great,
did you kill it?
I don't know what to call it. Introduction to yourself? I don't even know what she said.
I don't know.
I'm just
think so.
Sometimes they come back.
Have you killed one?
No, but they get shot a lot.
You've been all by yourself through this?
Yeah, I want my parents to come home now.
I think that might be a little while, you know?
Oh.
Look, I don't know what happened, but I'll look after you until then.
What should we do now?
Alright, I think we're gonna end it right here. I had some fun, but we're gonna continue in the next episode. See ya. Peace.